Welcome back everyone to Aussie Scrapper. And I'm going to start off by saying I'm sorry if you can hear the fan behind me, but it is about 45 degrees where I am at the moment and I really need it. So if you can hear it, I'm so sorry. The photos that I'm scrapping today are of my children with their granny and they're climbing the tree and she's very happy to be with her grandkids. And I seem to have a thing at the moment where I have to match all my photos. So I'm just using a sort of creamy coloured cardstock and then I'm going to match it a second time on this sort of brown paper from Kaisercraft, the Botanica collection, and the actual paper is called Seed. Abracadabra, both my photos are now magically all matted. And as you can see, I've done two layers of matting there. I'm going to be deciding which papers I'm going to use, and I do end up using this paper. It's from Kaisercraft, and I believe it's called Elegance. There you go, Elegance, and it's the Elizabeth. So I think it's the Elegance Collection Elizabeth. And I just made a banner from it, as you can see, and I'm going to play around with how I'm going to put put my photos on this. And this is my new toy. It's a dilutional stamp set and I just loved it for journaling. So I just recently bought it and I am going to stamp it on using my Trusted Little Misty, which is very grotty because, as you can see, it gets a lot of use. So I do fussy cut all around it. I don't think I show you all of that, or I hope I don't. Oh, you're lucky. I didn't make you watch it all. So now I'm just inking all sides with this Ranger R archival ink. And I'm sorry, but I didn't actually write down the colour that I used. I know it's a brown colour, but that's about as much as I know. And I also inked the edges of my little banner there. So I quite like how that's coming together. So I'm just going to be using one of the tags from this it's a Bella paper, but it's really old, so I don't even know if you can still get it in the shops. But yes, once again, I've cut it all out and I'm just inking all sides with that archival ink, whose colour I do not know. And what have I done here? It's come back to me. I'm just inking the sides, as you can see, and that little sticker says, "So happy together." And this little doily is from my stash as well, and I didn't want it in white, so I'm just inking it with some Distress Oxide, and I believe the colour is Vintage Photo. And I then go over it with another Distress Oxide, and it's Antique Linen, the second one that I use, just to give it a bit of highlight. Confession time. As much as I love this doily, I couldn't get it the right colour. The Vintage Photo, I thought there was too much brown happening in the layout, so then I tried highlighting it using the Antique Linen, as you saw, but I wasn't happy. And then I thought, oh, I'll just put some highlights around some parts of the heart in using the Colour Blast Colour Shimmer Cubes, and the colour is Blush, and I still wasn't happy. Moving along, my heart is all painted with that colour blush in shimmer cubes in the colour blush. So now I am just going to be doing some fussy cutting, and I do cut out quite a few of these lovely flowers, and I won't make you watch me fussy cut for a couple of hours. So I picked this paper. It's a crepe paper. It was from 2013. So yes, for using up more of my stash. And the paper was actually called Boy's Rule. So I'm just putting everything back together again and seeing if I like the composition or if I'm going to change anything. And I do fuss around a bit. And that I tried to make that little linen heart. I tried to make it work, but it just doesn't make it onto this layer. For some reason, it just didn't look right for me. So I'm just adding some twine to my little tag, and oh yes, I forgot I did some stitching on this. So I just got my little Amy Tangerine little pizza and my little mat there, and I make a lot of little holes so I can do some back stitching. So moving along, I am now using some embroidery thread in, it is a brown color, and I cannot remember if I used all six strands. I think I did. I think I wanted it really thick, so I used all six strands of the thread, and I'm just using the back stitch. That's all I'm doing, and I just love the texture that this gives to the layout. It does take a while, but I don't make you watch it all because I do stop the recording and I went and watched some TV while I did this. So now this is the next day, or I should say the next night, and my stitching's all done, and I'm putting the layout back together again and trying to see how everything's going to go, and this is the final stages. And while I'm narrating this in 45 degrees heat, may I add, I'm noticing that when I made this layout, I was wearing a jumper. So I know it was summer when I made this layout, so obviously we had a bit of a cool evening. Oh, look, this is the first time I used thread. Now, I'm a big fan of Missy Widdop, and she uses thread on nearly every layer, and I've actually made comments on some of the videos saying, one day I'm going to use thread, and this is the one day. It needed something, but I didn't know what that something was, and I just went, thread, I'm going to do Missy Widdop's thing and thread. And you know what? I think I'm converted. I loved it. It was just what it needed, that little bit of pop. Obviously, Missy doesn't watch my videos, so, you know, she won't know how excited I was that I actually finally been converted to using thread. So, enough chatting and inking some words again. And these little word stickers are from the Love Always collection, the Cocoa Vanilla Love Always collection, that is. So they say, one says captured, just there, and the bottom one that I just added there says forever. And then I take it apart and I went thread happy. I added some more thread. And this other one that I'm sort of matting on some of that brown paper, and it's going to go right up the top there, is doesn't really say anything. It's just hugs and kisses, you know, the zeros and crosses. So I am now, once again, trying to make this heart work. And I decided to cut the heart in half because it was too big the way it was. So I put one half on the top right-hand corner, and the other one is going to go in the bottom left-hand corner. And once again, I went rummaging through my stash, and I found these love hearts that I made a very long time ago. They're just handmade love hearts in beige, and I decided that that was going to be perfect on top of the other love heart, and I did put some thread just underneath it. And just some journaling and some little love hearts roller stamps, and it's all done. So thank you, everybody, and till my next layout, I hope you're all well. And I'll see you soon. Bye.